How to feel great on a poor night's sleep.
Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode.
Walter Tott says, are there any molecules that one can ingest, eat, smear on skin, etc., that can help with poor night sleep? And then follows up, I mean to try to correct fatigue, irritation due to poor sleep without actually taking a nap and without overstimulating the brain body that actually causes a recovery. I assume that poor sleep is a form of inflammation so that can be reduced while awake. Cold thermogenesis seems to clear up my head. So this is kind of a huge Pandora's box that I can only give an overview of here. So first of all, a poor night's sleep would be expected to lead to fatigue and irritation. And so Walter's asking, what can I do to try to recover from the poor night's sleep without causing maladaptive overstimulation? And that doesn't involve taking a nap. Okay, so first and foremost, I would say get rid of the poor night's sleep. And so that's, go through the checklist of 2 to 4 hours of blue light blocking before bed, 2 to 4 hour, up to 2 to 4 hour, depending on your needs, psychological winding down routine in which you clear everything off your to-do list, everything off your problem-solving list, focus on paperback fiction, TV, video games, movies, etc. Try 3 to 6 grams of glycine before bed to get a deeper sleep. Black out your room, cool your bed, find the lowest ambient temperature that doesn't make you cold. Create that with an air conditioner or a chili pad or an Uller or an 8 Sleep or whatever it is. Make sure that your noise is regulated so that if white noise is good for you, have the white noise. If all noise is bad for you, wear earplugs. If you're waking up in the middle of the night to pee, if your nighttime cortisol is high, deal with that through stress reduction. If you're waking up in the middle of the night to pee, Google Masterjohn waking up to pee, look at the nutritional suggestions there. There's a lot of micronutrients that are relevant. Salt before bed can help. You know, deal with all those things first, because I don't think there is any magical one-off cure for a poor night's sleep. You want to not get a poor night's sleep. Then if you do get a poor night's sleep, I think first of all, attitude can have a dramatic impact on the results. So if you're depressed or angry that you got a bad night's sleep, that will be 80 to 90% of your decrement in functioning, in my experience. So I remember one time, I used to have very bad insomnia. One time I read this book that basically gave me the idea that if I get a bad night's sleep, I should thank God for a bad night's sleep. So I started thanking God for a bad night's sleep whenever I got a bad night's sleep. And I found that my decrement in performance improved roughly 80%. 20% of that is physiological. 80% of it is the psychological effects of that physiological experience. So definitely cutting through the feedback loop in mindset, I think, can be huge. If cold exposure helps, then that tells me that boosting norepinephrine is what's helping. How do you boost norepinephrine? Probably best thing to do is try maca, gelatinized maca root. Increase to maybe start with a half teaspoon, increase up to 3 tablespoons, but do it slowly. Test the effect. That has natural compounds that inhibit norepinephrine uptake in the brain, which can act to extend the life of norepinephrine signals. Cold thermogenesis, do your thing. Cold shower, whatever it is, use it. That can certainly be pretty big. coffee absolutely antagonizes sleep loss. I think it's a terrible thing to use coffee chronically to deal with chronic sleep loss. But absolutely, if you have one poor night's sleep and you have a cup of coffee or you have an extra cup of coffee because of it, understand that you don't want to be overstimulated. But, you know, if you need the effect, the caffeine will absolutely antagonize the residual adenosine that is causing sleep pressure in the brain. Don't take any prescription drugs on my suggestion because I'm not a doctor, but Provigil is used to counteract sleep loss. Anything else you can do? excuse me. I do think there's nutrients that you want good status of. So eating enough protein, getting tyrosine, especially maybe supplementing tyrosine helps. Like maybe supplementing tyrosine an hour before a cold shower will improve the efficacy of the cold shower. I'm not so sure, but it might. But there's a lot of micronutrients involved in norepinephrine synthesis. So vitamin C, copper, salt, lots of things come into play. Antioxidant status. Cold exposure, maca root, coffee are probably the biggest things that you could use. Thank you, Walter, for your question. Hope that helps.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ MasterPass, a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. As a bonus, you also get to participate in monthly private Zoom Q&As with me. You can join the MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled out as Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for a 10% lifetime discount. From now through February or March, whatever it takes to get it done, I will be working full-time on finishing my Vitamins and Minerals 101 book while reserving a portion of my time for my consulting clients. You can pre-order my book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. I will try to respond to comments here when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.